Good morning, student. Welcome to the lab session of digital system design. Agenda of this lab is to design vending machine. Okay, we are going to design a vending machine which was asked in your first internal examination. So let us quickly see what is the definition of the vending machine and what are the specifications. So here, we are going to design vending machine with the following specification. We will be designing a vending machine which will give us water bottle as an output, okay, whose price is 15 rupees. The acceptable coin those are 5 rupees and 10 rupees. Okay, so that means you can insert total 15 rupees out of the combination of this inputs. Okay. So suppose you have a 5 rupees coin, then you can insert total 3 5 rupees coin in the machine, and you can have 15 rupees and you can get the water. Or if you have 2 5 rupees, 1 5 rupees and 1 10 rupees, then also you can get the water bottle. Please note that this machine will not give you change. Okay, so if you insert 2 10 rupees inside the vending machine will identify that these are the 2 10 rupees, but it will not give you back 5 rupees. That kind of machine that we will design right now. Okay, so let us try to understand what are the what would be the state diagram of this machine. Okay, so here we have two inputs, right? 5 rupees and 10 rupees. So here we have 5 rupees as an input. Okay, so in order to have a 15 rupees, we can get 5 plus 5 plus 5, or you can have the combination of 5 plus 10. Okay, now you can have 10 plus 10 also, and you can have 10 plus 5 also. Okay, so you can have any kind of a combination, but basically, since you will have only three states, and what are these three states? First stage is a reset state, or you can say S0 state. Second state is a 5 rupee state, and the third stage is a 10 rupees stage. Okay, so let us quickly try to understand the how to draw the state diagram. So first, here let us try to look at this first state. This is known as a reset state, okay, and it is a 0 rupee state. That means you have not inserted anything into the vending machine. Okay, so this is what the state is. Okay, now here, if you will not insert any state, that means if you are inserting 0 rupees, so you are inserting 0 rupees means you are not giving any input to vending machine. That is 0 input. Okay, so what will be the output? Output will be 0, right? Now say, for example, you are inserting 5 rupees into the machine. So when you insert 5 rupees into the machine and you are in S0 state, that is reset state, then next stage would be 5 rupees state. Okay, so if you give 5 rupees, then your next state would be S1 state. S1 state is a state where 5 rupees is achieved. Okay, but you cannot get output because output is 0, because you have not still achieved 15 rupees. That is why. Okay, now if you insert, because you have another input, that is a 10 rupees input, that means you can also input 10 rupees. So when you insert 10 rupees state, 10 rupees, then that the next state after S0 state would be the S2 state, that is a 10 rupees state. Okay, so if I will give input, that is as a 10 rupees, okay, if I give input as a 10 rupees, then my output will be 0, but state would be S2, because S2 is the state of 10 rupees. Okay, now say, for example, we have inserted 5 rupees. So if we have inserted 5 rupees, that means we are in a S1 state. Okay, now if you will, now we are in the 5 rupees state. Now if you will not give input at all, that means you are inserting 0 rupees, then what will vending machine will do? वेंडिंग मशीन विल वेट फॉर सम टाइम बट इफ यू विल नॉट इंसर्ट द कॉइन देन इट विल नॉट गिव यू द आउटपुट एंड इट विल गो बैक टू द रिसेट स्टेट. ओके सो लेट अस हैव अ लुक एट दैट. You are not giving the input, okay? So this will give you, this will go to the next state. The machine will wait for some period and then it will go to the reset state. Okay. Now, suppose for example, you are inserting 10 rupees coin. So you are in the 5 rupees state and you are inserting 10 rupees. So 5 plus 10 that becomes 15. So you will get the output. Okay. You will get the water bottle because the price of the water bottle is 15 rupees. So this 5 plus this 10 that becomes 15. So that is why you will get the output as a 1. Okay. Now see for example you don't have 10 rupees coin and you are in S1 state but you have 5 rupees. You have coins of 5 rupees. So if you will insert one more 5 rupees, then what will happen? You are having 5 rupees and you are inserting one more 5 rupees coin. So 5 plus 5 will become 10 rupees. So you will, now the next state, if you insert 5 rupees, the next state which will be achieved, that will be a 10 rupees state, that is a S2 state. Okay? But 5 plus 5, that becomes only 10. So, water bottle price is 15. So, still you have not achieved water bottle price. So, you will not get any output. Okay. So, that is for the S1 state. Now, we are in the S2 state. Okay. When we are in the S2 state and not giving any input. So, system, the machine will wait for some period and then it will give, it will go to the reset state without giving you output. Or without giving you back money. Okay. So, here is that thing. So, you are in 10 rupees state. You are not inserting anything. So, you will not get water bottle. Okay. Now, suppose after 10 rupees, if you insert 5 rupees. So, 5 plus 10 becomes 15. So, that means water bottle price achieved. When water bottle price is achieved, that means you will get a output. Okay. So here, after 10 rupees state, if you insert 5 rupees, so 10 plus 5 become 15 and you will get output as a 1. Okay. That means you will get a water bottle. Okay. Now, say for example, you are in the 10 rupees state and you do not have 5 rupees. Okay. But you have only 10 rupees. So, 10 rupees plus 10 rupees, that is equal to 20 rupees. So, your water, the price that you have or the coin you have inserted is a 20. Okay, but water bottle price is 15. But even though this machine will give you output because you have achieved minimum price of the bottle, that is 15 rupees. Okay, so you will get the water bottle, but you will not get the 5 rupees back. Okay, because this machine is designed to just give you output and not give you the change. Okay, so that is what about the state diagram of the vending machine without change. Okay, we will discuss about the vending machine with a change. Let us quickly discuss right now. Okay, so now we have the other vending machine. Now in the same vending machine, what we are going to do is we are going to have the output that is equal to water bottle as well as the change. Okay, so since we are giving the input that is 5 rupees and 10 rupees, we should also get the output as a 5 rupees. We should also get the changes as a 5 rupees and 10 rupees, okay? Which may not be possible every time, but let us quickly look at the diagram, okay? So again, we have a 3 state, S0, S1 and S2, where S0 is the 0 rupees state, S1 is the 5 rupees state and S2 is the 10 rupees state, okay? If we give input, when we are in the S0 state, And if we give input that is also equal to 0, then change would be 0. Because you are not giving the input, you will not get the output, okay? Next is if you give 5 rupees, okay? So if you insert 5 rupees, you should go into the state of 5 rupees, that is a S1 state. Here, whether you will get output or change, no, because you have not inserted sufficient amount of the input. So you will not get output, that is you will not get water bottle and you will not get the change as well. Here C stands for change, okay? And this will give you the status of the water bottle, okay? Now, let us try to understand if we insert 10 rupees coin in the state, when we are in the S0 state. If we insert 10 rupees state, then what will happen? Still you have not achieved the water bottle price. So there won't be any output of water bottle as well as there won't be any change. Because when you will get the change, when you will have, when you exceeded the water bottle price or when your time out, okay? So let us quickly see that. Okay, now we are in the S1 state, okay? S1 state is a 5 rupees state. Now you are not inserting anything. That means you are waiting for some period. But now not inserting anything, then what should happen? Machine should ideally give you the 5 rupees back. Okay, so that is what is here, right? So after 5 rupees, you are not inserting anything. That means you will get the 5 rupees back. Your 5 rupees will be given back to you. Okay, so that is first condition. Say for example, now you are giving 10 rupees after 5 rupees. So 10 plus 5 is total 15. So water bottle price is 15, which is exactly matching with your achieved state. That means 5 rupees plus 10 rupees. So you will get water bottle, but the change, you will not get change because you have paid exact amount of the money. Okay. Now, the third condition in the S1 state is the 5 rupees state. So you are in the 5 rupees state. And you are inserting one more 5 rupees. So 5 plus 5 is just 10 rupees, which is not water bottle price. So you will not get the water bottle as well as you do not get the change because 5 plus 5 is 10. So you have not either exceeded the money or not time out. So that is why C will be 0. Now, let us talk about the S2 state. In S2 state, if you are not... Like S2 state is a 10 rupees state. S2 state is a 10 rupees state. If you will not insert money in a given period, then what will happen? It will time out. So when it will time out, that means it will, because the machine is designed to give you money back. So if time out, then what will happen? You will get the change of 10 rupees back. Okay. And you will not get water bottle. Okay. Now, next is if you insert exactly 5 rupees. So, if you insert exactly 5 rupees, you will get the water bottle because this is 10 and you are inserting 5. 5 plus 10 is 15. So, water bottle will be out with the one output. Okay. And since you paid exact money, you will not get the change. Now, say for example, you are inserting 10 rupees. Instead of 5 rupees. So you are in the S2 state 10 rupees, right? Plus one more 10 rupees you are inserting. So 10 plus 10 becomes 20, but water bottle price is 50. So you should ideally get 5 rupees back. So here you can see that you should have 5 rupees back and you get bottle, that is, you get the output that is equal to 1 because you paid the money. Okay. So that is what the vending machine with change. Now what we are going to do, we are going to write a code, okay, quickly, okay, and then after, I already have one code which is prepared, but I will show you how to write a code, okay. So I hope that you have seen the video prepared by Dhara Madam in which she must have explained you about how to design a vending machine. More or less, the method is same. Okay, so let us try to make the code. Okay, So here you have to create one project that is vending machine, vending underscore machine underscore your ID number. Okay, then here on the cheap number you have to right click and you have to add new resources. Then you have to select the source that is Verilog module, key proper name, okay, vending underscore machine underscore whatever your number is. Okay, so that is it. Okay, what are the input? Your input would be clock, reset, input. Your output would be 1 bit output, that is output. Here you have to select output. Okay, so you will see your machine here. Okay, since our input are three different combination, two different combination, because it is not it is 5 rupees and 10 rupees. Okay, so we should have 2 bit value of input, that means 00010. Okay, so that is why we are selecting the size of input that is equal to 2 bit. Here we will write in comment 0 01, that will be considered as a 5 rupees, and 10 will be considered as a 10 rupees. Okay, now we will select the, here we will use a parameter. Parameter is a kind of a variable, which is a, it is a kind of a constant. Okay, that is very useful. Okay, and we will use parameter in order to define the states. Okay, so here S0 state, that is a reset state. Here we will use 2 bit of the state, because we have one state that is 0 state, 01 state that is for S1 state and S2 state. Okay, so we need to define three different state here. Okay, S0 state, S1 state, S2 state. S1 state that is a 01 state, S2 state that is a 10 state. Okay, here we should add the comment that S1 state that is nothing but 5 rupees state. Okay, here S0 state that is a reset state. Okay, and S2 state that is a 10 rupees. Okay, now we will define two reg. Okay, that is used for current state, that is currency state, and another variable of another reg, that is a next state. Both of them, this current state and next state, should be having the 2 bit value. Okay, so that is why here we are going to define them vector, and size of that vector is 01, that is a 2 bit. Okay, here since we are going to use output variable directly, out directly in the always block, we need to define that is as a reg. Okay, now we are going to take the insertion of the coin into the vending machine at passage of the clock. That is why we will use the always block. So in the always, at the rate of pause age of the clock, first of all we will see if our reset is 1 or not. If our reset is 1 equal to 1, then our current state and next state that will become reset state. Okay. Else our current state is equal to next state. Okay, you will understand why I am doing this later on. Okay, now I hope it is visible to you. Let me just increase the size. Size of the font. Okay, now here what we are going to do, we are going to use a case statement in which we are going to check the current state of the current state, and based on the input given, we will be looking for the next state. Okay, so now our anyway first state would be 0. Okay, and in this we will be checking that if our input is equal to 0, if our input is equal to 0, what should happen? Please make a habit of whenever you are using any loops or loops, you should always use this begin and end, then try to write something in the bracket or in between the in the space between begin and end. Okay, so we are in the S0 state and our input is 0. Say for example our input is 0, so let us quickly have a look at the state diagram. Okay, so we are in the S2 state, S0 state, and our input is 0. So our output would be 0 and next state would also be 0. So that we need to define. So let us quickly do that here. So our next underscore state, would be S0. Our out is equal to 0. Okay, that is what it is. Okay, if now we are using else if statement, because our input could be 0, could be 5 rupees or could be 10 rupees. So if our input that is equal to 2-B01, that means your input is 5 rupees. Okay, then I will be copy pasting this thing here. Okay, so if my input is 01, that means 5 rupees, then next state would be S1 because we are in the 0 state. Okay, so let us quickly look at this. Suppose you are inserting 5 rupees. 5 rupees means 01 input. So then next state would be S1 and output would be 0. Okay, so that we are going to do it here in the code. Okay, output would be 0. Okay, what else? Next condition you should get? If input is equal to 2-B10. 10 means 10 rupees state. Okay, so for this, what you will have? You will have the next state that is equal to S2 state, which is a S2 state is a 10 rupees state, which is written here. Okay, and the output would be 0. So this is your first S0 condition. Okay, now the same condition you have to say for every state you have to write this condition. Okay, so now this is first is S0. Now let us look for S1. And then the same thing that we will repeat for S2 as well. Okay, now let us look at the S2 state. For when you are in the S1 state, okay, and your input is 0, your next state would be 0 and output would be 0. If you are in the S1 state and you are inserting the 5 rupees, so you are in the 5 rupees state and you are inserting one more 5 rupees, 5 plus 5 become 10 rupees, 10 rupees means the S2 state. So your next state would be S2, but your output would be 0. Okay, if you are in the S1 state and you are giving the input that is 10 rupees, that means 5 rupees is already there and you are inserting 10 rupees. So 10 plus 5 becomes 20, so your next state would become 0. But your output will become 1. Okay, so that is what for the S2 state. Okay, similarly, that is for S1 state. Now let us look at the S2 state. S2 state means it is our 10 rupees state. Okay, it is of 10 rupees state. Okay, so when you are in the 10 rupees state and not giving any input, so if you are not giving any input, then next state would be 0. okay, and there won't be any output. Now you are in 10 rupees state and you are inserting 5 rupees. So when you insert 5 rupees, that means you are inserting 10 plus, your total rupees will be 10 plus 5, that is a 15. So your next state would become S0, but your output will become 1. Okay. Now, that is what the S2 state is. Now, if you are in the 10 rupees state and you are inputting more 10 rupees, one more 10 rupees, so 10 plus 10 become 20. Okay, so that means you have achieved at least 15 rupees price. That is why your next state will become S0, but you will get the output. Okay, so that is what about all the case statement. After you complete all the statement of S1, S0 and S2, you should write end case here. And then you should add one end and one end. Okay, so that is what your thing is. Okay, I think I have inserted two more ends, I guess. Okay. So that is what about the entire program. Okay, I might have some problem here, that is I will show you later on. Okay, now let me quickly see what the, okay, so there are too many ends here. So now you can see that my program is not giving me any kind of a error. Okay, now here you should comment on every state, that is a, this is a 5 rupee state, this is a reset state, so that you will not have any confusion later on. Okay, now let us quickly make a test bench. We will click on vending machine here, right click, new source, Verilog text fixture, give appropriate name like vending underscore machine underscore TV, that is for test bench. Okay, so here we will have a clock that is equal to 0, reset is equal to 0 and input is equal to 0. Okay, I already have made this bench, so I am directly taking it from somewhere. Okay, but you guys should know how to write this bench, okay? Okay, let me quickly explain you what I have done here, okay? So we should be looking at the begin block, okay, begin and end block. Rest of the block will be you will understand. Okay, first of all, we have given the input, that is the reset state is 1 first of all at the beginning of the simulation, and clock is 0. Okay, and we are generating the clock, that is at every 5 second clock would be negative of the complement of the clock. So every 5 seconds this status of the clock will change. Okay, initially we have kept the reset, that is equal to 1, and after 6 seconds your reset will become 0, input that is equal to 1. So input we are setting to 1. Okay, 1 here, 1 is 0, 1 here literally. Okay, you can have a different state. Okay, so this is how you can write your test bench, and this is your vending machine design. Okay, so now we are going to simulate this vending machine. So let us quickly look at the output. Okay, let me first of all see whether I have made the machine correctly or not, and then you can get it. Okay. Okay, so now let us have a quick look at the things that we have done. So, okay, so now let us try to look at the output. Okay, first of all, we will arrange this clock like this way. First of all, we'll put reset, then we will have clock, then we have input, and then we have output. Okay, so since reset is on, nothing will be going to happen. Okay, so now here at this point, at 6 nanoseconds, you can see that your reset is zero. Now, always block will not be executed until the next process, because we have given the things and we have written our code like that way. Okay. Now here at this process of the clock, now again our always block will look for the RST, that is the reset. So at this process of the clock, our RST is zero. Okay. So now it will go to the next block, and in the next block you will see that our input is 01 means 5 rupees. So at this point, since the input is 5 rupees, your output would be 0. So that you can see here. Okay, now we should go for the next clock passage of the clock, and we see that what is the input. So if I will click here, you will see that at this position, the input is 10. Here you can see 10. 10 means 10 rupees. So 5 rupees plus 10 rupees, that becomes 15 rupees. So that is why your output is 0. Output is 1 here. That you can easily see. Okay. So that is what you need to understand. Okay. Now at the next process of the clock, again it will see that what is the input. Again here the input is 10. So now it is 10 rupees. Now at this process also it will check for the input, that is again 10 rupees. So 10 plus 10, again it becomes 20. That means water price is exceeded this 15 rupees. That is why again you have a output. Okay, so this is how you should see. Now, sometimes you do not understand that what is going on, and you want to sit, you want to find out that what is the current state, what is the next state. Okay, so in that case, you should go, or you should click on instant and process name, where you should click on UUT, and you can see here current state and next state. So you can just click on this whatever variable you want to insert here, and then you can just drag that component here like this way. So you can see now C state and next state. Now you have, in order to look for the changes in the C state and next state, you should press on relaunch button. Okay, and it is asking me that do I need to save the changes. No, I don't want to save, so I will press on no, and you can see here now. So this is how you can check the current state. See here, let us quickly have a look of here. Okay, since this is RST, when RST that is equal to 1, my current state and next state that becomes 0. Okay, on next passage of the clock, the current state will be the next state will be changed. Okay, and that becomes 01. Again you will see the next state, my next state would be 0, because 01 plus 10, that becomes 15. So that is how you can check your current state and the next state in order to verify your output. Okay, I will be showing you test bench one more time. Okay, this is our test bench which I have written here. The earlier which I have showed is different one. Okay. So you can see here that at 6 nanosecond my RSP is 1 and input is 1 and output after 19 second I have taken my input, that is equal to 2. Input is equal to 2, that means it is 0 1 in binary, that is 10 rupees. Okay, here 10 in binary is 10 rupees and 0 1 in binary, that is equal to 5 rupees. Okay, so this is the test bench that you could set. Suppose you don't want to set this is equal to this, then just now I am going to make changes here. Okay, you already have seen this one, so I am going to just comment this thing and I am going to take this as 1. That means I am continuously adding 5 rupees. So what will happen in that case? Okay, that we are going to see. Let us see that in the waveform. Okay. So now you could see here. Now this RSP is 0 here, so we are not bothered about this state. Here the input is 5 rupees, okay, so there won't be any output. 5 rupees plus again input is 0 1, that means 5 rupees, so there is no output. And here one more 5 rupees, so 5 rupees plus 5 rupees plus 5 rupees, that becomes 15 rupees. So that is why output is 1 at this point. Okay. So that you can easily see over here. Again, at the next passage, input is again 5 rupees plus 5 rupees plus 5. That means now 15 rupees state is achieved. So that is why this is 15 rupees. Okay. So now this is how you can change the different input combination. Instead of 1, you can write here 2-B10. Now let us try to look at that position, that what will happen if they directly give input that is equal to 10 rupees and 10 rupees. Okay, so now relaunch. So now let us try to look at the output. This is our clock. This at this clock we get the input 10 rupees. 10 plus 10, 20, so the output is 1. Next is 10 rupees, 10 plus 10, 20, so the output is 1. For 10 rupees and 10 rupees, output is 1. So that is how you can define various input inside the test bench, and you can check your output. Also, you can check the current state and next state here, like this way, which I have explained already. So now, suppose for example, I want to add the change, right? I want that my machine should give the change to me. Then what I should do in my vending machine, instead of the output, that is out, you should have one more out, that is equal to change, and that is of 2-bit. 2-bit means 1:0. By 2-bit, because 01, that is for 5 rupees change, 10, that is equal to for 10 rupees change, and in respective state, you should, wherever we have defined our output is equal to 0, here we should give output variable change that is equal to 0 or 1, whatever you want. Suppose it is a 5 rupees change, then you should ideally write it 2-B01. That means it will give you 5 rupees change. So that is how you can design the vending machine with the change as well. Okay. But I want all of you to write this by yourself. Okay. Try to write this by yourself. Okay. Do not copy. Okay. From anywhere else. Okay, so this is the vending machine TB. टेस्ट बेंच, यू कैन ट्राई टू राइट योर वेंडिंग मशीन टेस्ट बेंच बाय योर सेल्फ. ओके, एनीथिंग यू वॉन्ट टू नो देन आई विल बी देयर ड्यूरिंग द लेबोरेटरी सेशन एज वेल. यू कैन आस्क मी एनी डाउट इफ यू हैव. ओके, सो दैट इज वॉट फॉर टूडेज सेशन. ओके, थैंक यू एवरी वन फॉर पेइंग द अटेंशन.